There are only 22 days until the all-important midterm elections, and OutFront is going to bring you a race to watch every single day until Election Day. Tonight, we're going to take a look at one of the closest Senate races in the country, Arizona, where Democrat Kyrsten Sinema and Republican Martha McSally are facing off tonight in a key debate. Kyung Lah is out front.
In the neck-and-neck battle for Arizona's Senate seats, voters like Denise Giannotti could hold the key to victory.
I'm registered Republican.
You're at a Democratic event, though.
Yes.
Why is that?
Ever since Donald Trump got elected, everything that he represents, I can't. It literally physically makes me sick.
I know we're going to win this election.
She's now supporting Democrat Kyrsten Sinema, a congresswoman running a center-left campaign, packing offices in Republican districts like the North Phoenix suburbs.
I'm here to support the Democrats.
Sinema needs to.
It's either phone banking or canvassing.
Registered Republicans and independents outnumber Democrats in Arizona, a state where the latest CNN poll finds a majority of voters disapprove of President Trump.
It's so important, especially after this Kavanaugh thing, that we get women in there.
Martha McSally's a woman.
Yeah,
you know, she's a barrier breaker. Why not go for her?
Yeah, no. She's a Donald Trump supporter.
Martha.
Mr. President.
But it wasn't always that way.
I'll admit it.
Whoa.
I did try. She was married.
Republican Martha McSally criticized Trump after the Access Hollywood tape. Still won't say if she voted for him, but now eager to share a stage with him.
What role would you like the president to play in this last stretch?
Well, he's going to come out. So we've been coordinating with the White House to come out to remind especially Republicans about what's at stake.
Wow, there she is, right there.
National Republicans have been descending on Arizona, rallying for McSally. The goal? Energize the base.
We need you to deliver the vote. We've got to make sure they get to the polls, and we've got to be sure that they vote Republican.
Are you concerned that Republicans and independents won't be coming home to Martha?
And I think we're going to have a record turnout of people.
Victory on three.
But McSally herself acknowledged that's a challenge.
Victory! This is the insanity of what's going on right now, right? If we just get Republicans to vote for Republicans, then we are going to win up and down the ticket.
And you have even said, we have to encourage Republicans to vote Republican. What do you mean by that?
Again, make sure you're registered Republican for a reason, right? She's tried to pretend she's essentially right of center right now, and she's not because she's trying to win over Republicans. So we need Republicans and right-leaning independents to wake up, look at our records, look at our past, and make a good choice.
But her radical record puts us all at risk.
Republicans are hammering Sinema's past. She was once a Green Party anti-Iraq war activist, organizing 15 protests, working with one group that, in a flyer, depicted a U.S. soldier as a skeleton.
Thank you so much, Kyrsten. Thank you so much.
But in Congress as a Democrat, she developed a moderate voting record.
You know, Martha has chosen to run a negative campaign based on lies and distortions. That's her choice. She can do that if she wants.
Republicans believe that those negative ads are working because the race is tightening.
Well, we've continued to maintain our lead, and I'm going to work every single day to earn every vote of every Arizona that I can.
Now, the two Senate candidates face off in their first and only debate in just about an hour, and this is going to be taking place before Election Day. And early voting here in the state of Arizona has already begun. I want you to take a look through this glass. What you're seeing here is the Maricopa County Elections Department. These employees, they are testing tabulators. There are more than 400 tabulators that they're going to be testing. This is going to take a week. Actual vote counting will begin in just about 2 weeks, Jake.